America, I should say, fell in love with young Danica McKellar in the late 80s and early 90s as Winnie Cooper on the iconic first run of the show, The Wonder Years. And of course, she's gone on to be in shows and movies on the Hallmark Channel, among many other things. Danica was also a math major at UCLA and never lost her love for numbers. She has had several math-related books for kids on the bestseller list. Her latest is Double Puppy Trouble. And Danica joins us live this morning. Thanks for being with us.
Oh, thank you so much. That movie you guys were showing, that's The Winter Palace, from not from Hallmark, but from GAC Family. It's a new network that I'm doing my movies on.
Oh, gotcha.
It's a fun movie, yeah. I think it re-airs actually on Saturday.
How many have you done on that network? And we've seen you in a bunch of Hallmark movies, too. All in all, have you done 20 of them?
A lot. Yeah, 16 on Hallmark Channel, and then on Great American Family, or GAC Family, The Winter Palace that you just saw that re-airs this Saturday, and then my new Christmas movie will also be on Great American Family in December, yeah.
That's a lot of upbeat, falling in love, isn't it, Danica?
That's what we need. We need more happiness in the world.
Yes.
You know, there's a lot of crazy stuff in the news. And so, I mean, you guys would know better than anyone. And so I'm just thrilled to be able to provide happy entertainment. And then, of course, with my books, bring some smiles to kids' faces who are struggling in math.
Are you still asked about your time on The Wonder Years? Is that still a fun chapter to look back on?
Absolutely. Oh, I love it. And you know, the thing is, a lot of the parents who grew up with The Wonder Years now have kids who are struggling in math. And I've got all my math books at McKellarMath.com for ages 0 through 16, all the way through high school geometry. And so it's really like a full circle moment for me. And when I meet these adults who are my age saying, oh my gosh, I grew up with you, and now my child is growing up and getting through math because of your books. It's so beautiful.
So can you give me an idea, why do you think the U.S. is always so far behind other countries in math, and why do girls especially seem to shy away from math?
I mean, it's cultural. We don't celebrate our mathematicians and scientists here. We celebrate our athletes and performers. And so, you know, in order to see it as valuable, you have to understand its value. And if it's not going to make you glamorous, then what's it going to do? Well, one of the things that I promote is showing kids not just that math, yes, is going to make you smarter and more savvy with your finances, so that you don't get ripped off later in life, which is what happens to adults who don't pay attention to numbers, but also it just sharpens your brain and it makes you a better problem solver no matter what you want to do. Getting that confidence that comes from feeling smart and knowing that you are enough because of something you've built for yourself, which is struggling through a math problem and then staying with it, sticking with it, and proving to yourself that you are now stronger and smarter than you thought. That kind of confidence is a gift that kids can give themselves through things like my books, or really any kind of hard work that then they stick with it long enough to pay off, but I try to make it fun so they stick with it. That is a gift that you give yourself that no one else can give you and no one else can take away. And that kind of fortitude and resilience is one of the best gifts that math has to offer.
Danica, what age do you think is the most critical in terms of keeping kids interested in math? Does it happen in junior high and in high school, or is it younger?
Middle school is the time when kids, especially girls, start to lose confidence in math. So even before their grades drop, their confidence will drop. It's because you think you're not going to be good at something. And then when you do struggle, instead of going, oh, well, it's just a temporary stumbling block, girls in particular tend to believe, since they're trained to believe that their smarts is not their most valuable asset, they go, oh, well, you know what? I knew I didn't belong. I've known it all along. Look at this one math problem that I can't do. See, it's evidence. But no, it was just one math problem. So training kids to understand, no, you do belong here. Girls, you do belong here. Everybody belongs here. Math is for you. And it can be fun and it can be exciting. And you can have an understanding of how it's actually valuable in your life. Look, kids have to be in math class anyway. Why not take the opportunity to make it fun and accessible so that they enjoy the process and so they learn to embrace their smarts, something that we don't see enough of and enough encouragement of in the world?
Well, I know a lot of parents were regretting it during the pandemic because they had to be the teachers of the math to their kids, and they're like, what is going on?
Yes, and so to answer your question, the middle school is the most crucial time.
Yeah.
However, you can't start soon enough.
Yeah.
So that's why I've got books like Double Puppy Trouble, my new one, that's really fun and sweet and just creates this happy association with math. Because what is more happy than puppies? It's about this girl who wants more of everything. Her name is Moxie. She wants more of everything, But be careful what you wish for, because she finds a magical stick that's got a button on it. And when you press that button and it's pointed at something, that thing doubles. Ah. And so she decides to double their puppy, gotcha. But the button gets stuck. So it's 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. Puppy mayhem. But in the end, it teaches a very valuable lesson, not just how to double numbers, which is the math lesson that I sneak in, but also that sometimes less is more and to be grateful for what we have.
Well, Danica, thank you so much. The book is Double Puppy Trouble. You can find her at McKellarMath.com and on social media. Have a great weekend. Good to talk to you.
Thanks so much.
Thank you. You too.